the offensive line. He says, but I think we're going to scrap that shuttle of the quarterback a little bit. Look for more of the leader, Stanley Jackson, in the second half for the Ohio State Buckeyes.
All right, Jack, the Bucks will get it to start the second half. And you can see Jackson, helmet on, and their numbers from the first half here.
Well, this number at the bottom, though, that's 10, minus 10 yards by Pepe Pearson. That's the biggest problem.
Jankowski pumps another one. Riley says, let's just take it out on the 20-yard line, and let's see what the Bucks are able to come up with here.
I never knew I had to be quiet before a kicker kicked off the ball so you could hear the thunder thump.
I'm getting ready for the World Cup. You know, I like to watch these soccer guys.
You know, I talked to Jankowski before practice the other day, and I said, well, who helped you the most with learning how to kick a football? He said, the biggest thing he had to overcome was the fact that the soccer ball and the football are different shapes.
So here we go. Man, what an astute young man he is. Jackson hands it off, and there's Pearson with his best run of the game. Powering on out to the 26-yard line. Here's your defensive leaders from the Seminoles in the first half, and they had a lot of them, let me tell you. That doesn't reflect the pressure that some of those fellows were bringing up front, too. And one is number 85, big fella, at left defensive end. Angle. An extra yard. Coward steps up between him and the tackle, and they run Pepe Pearson again. If they spot it, it'll be enough for a first down. But do I see another yellow flag down there, Dan?
No, they did spot it, though, across the 30-yard line, Brent. And that's a great start for Ohio State. You can almost get a feeling that perhaps John Cooper really might have laid into his ball club and said, hey, listen, let's get back to Ohio State football. Let's get the ball in the tailback behind the fullback, and let's run right at Florida State.
Pretty aggressive on those two plays, and an injured Seminole, so it's a positive start here for the second half. Pittman is down, number 95.
And the positive thing for Pepe Pearson is he now has 0 yards rushing on 8 carries. Here's Pittman, number 95. Check out his injury here. What that injury was, but I'm sure that he'll be all right.
Lumpkin comes in from the Buckeye sideline along Boston's ready to go. Try Pepe again on that isolation play. Without push in there, the Buckeyes might have found something. That is close to another 10-yard gain that time on first down.
That's a good point, Brent, because Bush is the second leading tackler for Florida State with 97 on the year. He went out early in the first quarter. But this is 3 straight isolation plays for John Cooper and the Buckeyes.
So Mickey will have to change his alignment defensively with him featuring the iso play. The fullback Keller right straight ahead. Breaks it across midfield. This is Buckeye football.
Remember, Rob Murphy is done for the day, too. Watch the left side here as they give the ball to the fullback, Keller. 4 rushes now for 32 yards for Ohio State. And positive yards as Keller bounces off the safety and falls across midfield.
NFL coaches have known for years, against a great defensive line, you try to run right at them. Don't let them start coming upfield on you. And the Buckeyes are trying to keep it going. Don't get off the run. Here comes Pepe again. Just keep pounding. That's what you got to do against great rushmen. It's been the formula in football games forever, and it's not going to end.
And watch this time. Ohio State's going to send the fullback this way, and they're going to give the ball to Pearson. And have a little misdirection now when you've been pounding them straight ahead. You want to give them a different look. Not as many yards that time as Lamont Green, number 45, makes the play.
That time Wadsworth got caught up on the garbage. He was trying to pressure in from outside. Here comes second down, and let's see if the Buckeyes put up their first pass of the second half. Going to keep it right there with Pepe and nothing doing. He was jumped. And now they're almost forced to pass unless Stanley Jackson can break one running. So D. Miller will replace Rambo and bring the play in from the Buckeye sideline.
Taking a long time to get this play in.
Too long.
Takes a long time sometimes when you're down by 18 and you got a third and eight.
Well, couldn't get to get set down there on the Wadsworth side. Then with the tight end over there. Give Jackson the shotgun. He's going to run out of it. And they were ready. Smith, the safety, jumps the play and a penalty flag down at the 43-yard line. Big mistake.
No, it certainly can be. As Shevin Smith, number 30, looked like he just crossed into that neutral zone. Good job by Stanley Jackson with the hard count. Eight penalties now against Florida State, but that's kind of their norm. They average 10 per game.
So they need just over 3 yards. That makes it a little bit different. They'll move Stanley up under center. The Knowles cross the scrimmage line. They're going to run Pearson slanting. And he got the first down for the Buckeyes. Good looking play against that defensive front.
Pearson, a very determined runner here in the second half. Had to be embarrassed by the lack of production the Buckeyes had in the first half. As he gets inside Burris. Picks up that first down by himself primarily. He's got 6 carries so far here in the second half.
Opening drive, second half. Buckeyes drive to the 37. Johnson back into the defensive line. Pearson goes right at him.
You know,
about a yard.
In the first half, most of the running plays for Ohio State were draw plays or trap plays, trying to bring Wadsworth up the field and then run inside him either by Stanley Jackson or by Pearson. They've just decided the heck with those draw plays and trap plays. We're just going to come right at you with Pearson behind Matt Keller and try to negate some of that team speed and quickness of Florida State.
Double tight end, Wisniewski with Lumpkin for the Bucks. Pepe gets a call, slides across the 35 to the 34-yard line, but this is going to be third and long coming up. Here's a big play for the Bucks. Wadsworth coming down the line. Jacobs making the call upstairs, and he needs one here.
And what he's looking at is a nickel coverage coming in for Florida State as they bring in extra defensive backs.
Samari Rule forced out because of an injury in that first half, and so Saunders has been over at that corner, left side of the defense. The freshman's on the right side. Jackson, Coward's picked up on the blitz, fires complete to D. Miller. Great pass under pressure for a Buckeye first down.
Absolutely, Brent. Pressure was coming on Jackson. He's a little bit quicker than Joe Germain setting up. And he feels Bryant from the blind side. And throws a great pass to pick up a first down. That's the first pass in the second half, 9 runs prior to this one.
Buckeyes drive inside the 25-yard line. Keller and Pearson. Jackson starts Lumpkin as an H-back. Power to the left, and they'll run short side away, and Pearson's cut off. Number 95 comes on over, Julian Pittman.
And here is Pittman, number 95. He does a great job of taking the inside. Actually, he's looped to the outside.
They looped good. Him with Wadsworth that time, Dan.
That was excellent. 95 and 85 confused me.
Jackson with a penalty flag flying. Going to throw the ball into the end zone. Whistle dead.
I'll start. Hop it.
That was their hurts.
See who clinched there. It looked like it was the right tackle, Eric Goldstein, but who can blame him? He's been staring at number 85 all evening.
This is going to make it second down and 16. 8:47 to go in the third.
I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't see Jackson on some type of either rollout or quarterback draw here.
The play being signaled in. Miller goes to the short side, Boston to the wide side of the field. Penny is the fullback, and they run Pearson straight up the middle. Inside the 25-yard line. That's just about the original line of scrimmage.
Boy, was there a heck of a collision at the end of this play. It's a draw play to Pepe Pearson. And watch the collision. As he puts his head down, Chevin Smith comes in. Todd Pryor, number 35, with the big hit.
Lumpkin gets down opposite Wadsworth. Toss play is to Pearson. Slant left side. Holes there. Pepe in a foot race to the 17-yard line. Short of the first down. And the field goal unit comes trotting onto the field. It'll be Stultz.
Boy, another big hit. And this time there are two Florida State Seminoles that aren't getting up. It's been a long, impressive, ground-dominated drive by Ohio State.
And
taking their toll on this knoll.
I think there should have been a face mask at the end of that play, too. Let's take a break here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl, and we'll come right back.
In 1993, we changed everything. Dodge became the new Dodge, and the new Dodge became Intrepid. Now we're changing the way cars are created. Today's new Intrepid is the world's first car designed, assembled, and proven on computers, enabling a degree of precision never before possible. Welcome to the world of the new Dodge Intrepid. We're changing everything. Again.
How fast do I really have to be going before I get a ticket?
Law's the law.
What is it, 5-10 miles over?
Deli style legs. Ooh. Well, it's a guessing game out there, Mike. No, let me show you something.
72?
Yeah.
Let me see that. 90. Hey, you're fast.
Quit crunching your lunch. New Lay's deli style.
Every year I try to quit smoking cold turkey. This year is my year. I'm committed. I'm psyched. And I have help. Nicorette gum. To help control my cravings. It's not like the patch. Nicorette lets me decide how much nicotine to use and when to use it, so I can stop smoking now. The idea is, by this time next year, to save enough money by not smoking, to be not smoking in Cancun.
Nicorette gum helps you fight your cravings, your habit, your way. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
This Monday, the practice moves to Mondays. Want to come along?
Yeah, Dan, I think if they call this face mask first, that's a first down. What'd you think about this?
I think Sam Coward, number one, that's a face mask right there. Now watch the hit there between Tay Cody and Dexter Jackson. Luckily for the Seminoles, both of them got up and apparently are going to be all right.
And they get a break now because Stultz will attempt a field goal. Bartholomew is going to put this down at the 25-yard line. So this is going to be a 35-yard attempt. Buckeyes need this one down 21-3. They've given up 21 unanswered points. And Stultz snaps that. 21-6. Now the Buckeyes need to come up with a little defense here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl and try to keep things going with Stanley Jackson. We'll be right back.
Thus saith the Lord, with the raging flood.
We just want the money!
He makes an end of those who oppose him.
$3 million.
And he pursues his enemies into darkness. On January 16th, prepare for Hard Rain. Hard Rain, rated R. Starts Friday, January 16th in theaters everywhere.
You're so lucky. Not one gray hair.
When a woman can run her fingers through your hair and can't tell you blend away your gray, that's a natural-looking result. And that's just what you get with a hair color called Just for Men. Its unique formula blends away gray. Shampoo in, then rinse, all in 5 easy minutes. And it matches your gray to your natural color, so nobody knows, even close up.
I just love your hair.
Just for Men. It looks so natural, even she can't tell.
Before we built one part for the new Dodge Intrepid, we built the whole car digitally. That way, we were able to test more than 2,000 engines, numerous suspensions, a multitude of seats, and a vast number of headlamps. The result is impressive. You might say, it's one in a million. The new Dodge Intrepid. We're changing everything. Again.
We're like Thelma and Louise.
The girls' road trip to Woman Fest.
And Paige.
Nobody's afraid of being stared at or judged. Oh, my God, look at those freaks.
And all-new Ellen, ABC Wednesday.
ABC Sports presentation of the 1998 Nokia Sugar Bowl. Brought to you by the NASDAQ stock market. Shaping the new world of investing. Hope that next year shapes up as a good year for investors as this year was. A lot of folks enjoying their riches out there on Bourbon Street. Weekend, Stoltz pounds it. Kickoff. And Springer thinks better of it because Feaster tells him not to come out, and that was a wise decision. And now, time for the big cat to make his presence felt here.
It's been difficult for him. Only one tackle so far for the Buckeyes.
Thad Busby trots onto the field to start the second half for the Noles. Miner, then his running back. The freshman's gone all the way at that tailback spot. Warwick, E.G. Green, both out to the wide to the right side of the field. Pearsall, the tight end. They open with Glenn at fullback. They run the toss with Miner. Not much doing there. Number 95 was coming hard, and that's Jimmy Bell. Now you wonder about 21-6 settling in and getting a little conservative, trying to get back in the rhythm after the long intermission at a bowl game. It's amazing sometimes.
Yeah, but I don't think Bobby Bowden's going to get conservative, although Travis Miner's out of the game.
And Feaster replaces him. Inside handoff to Feaster, cuts back, slips a tackle before Damon Moore brings him down at that 34-yard line for a first down. The Bowden family, quite a collection of coaches, huh, Jackaroot?
Yeah, indeed there are. You've got Jeff working with his daddy, you got Terry working at Auburn, and Tommy taking over the Tulane Green Wave. What's it like to be the son of a coaching icon and have to compete against him, Tommy?
He's come over here chasing my players, that dirty rat, him and Terry both.
We'll ask him another question after this play.
Okay. I love Tommy's question. Gets a handoff down to Feaster again, and nothing doing on the first down. Jack?
Tommy, what's the biggest thing you learned from your dad, though, in terms of coaching?
Well, I tell you, really, patience and perseverance, because coming to a program like Tulane was the last few years, I kind of learned how to do it, because it was a similar situation what he had at Florida State 20 years ago.
Tell you, Brent, the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree, and his brother will be playing tomorrow.
Yeah, I tell you what he can do is go get Bobby's Papa's second stringers. Bring them here to Tulane, and they'd be plenty good enough. When you think about this defense, just think of who they play. Probably their best opponent other than Florida is their own team. Great play fake, and Berry doesn't buy it. What a play by Berry that time. Busby with a fine fake, but number one said, uh-uh.
They've been crowding the line of scrimmage with both Berry and Damon Moore. This is a fine athletic play. Right side of the screen. Berry doesn't buy that fake. Gets up in the air and bats the ball right back to Busby.
And that puts him in third and long. So a shotgun look now for Busby.
pressure. Down he goes, the big cat, number 45. His presence is finally recognized in New Orleans.
And would you believe it? It's only his second sack of the entire year after picking up 11 last year. But he is an impact player. He got close to Busby on the play before, and this time he's not going to let number 12 get away.
Go to Buckeye defense, forcing a Seminole punt. Boston will try to give them some field position, see if they can come right back down here. They've already scored with a field goal. Took the high snap, got it off. Boston fair catch, 36-yard line. The Butkus Award winner, number 45 from Westerville, Ohio. Still only a sophomore, and we'll be right back.
The new Dodge wanted to take the sport utility concept to a higher level. Enter the new Durango. Its best-in-class power, cargo space, and seating for up to 8 raise the bar considerably, as do its strongest-in-class frame and its stable, longer, wider stance. Dodge Durango, a higher form of sport utility, from top to bottom. Durango, new ground for the new Dodge.
I'm a numbers guy. Don't give me words. Give me a number. One day, Upjohn invites me to help test the new Rogaine. I hated losing my hair. I said yes. They tell me this new Rogaine Extra Strength for Men is more concentrated. It gets more to the root to grow more hair. Don't give me the more. Give me the number. Yeah, I am seeing hair, but give me the number. They give us the number. 45% more hair than with original Rogaine. 45% more hair with the new Rogaine. I say, give me the Rogaine.
A company most people never heard of is changing the way we fight cancer and kidney failure. By inducing the body to produce blood cells, chemotherapy and anemia patients are gaining new strength. Helping to grow blood cells helped Amgen become the world's largest biotech company. Where do you learn about companies with such pioneering spirit? NASDAQ. Shaping the new world of investing.
ABC Sports presentation of the 1998 Nokia Sugar Bowl brought to you by Nokia Wireless Phones. Inspired technology with a human touch. The new Dodge, it's about change. Paramount Pictures, Hard Rain. And Lay's. Make your lunch special with Lay's. Seminoles are trying to make their stay in New Orleans something special. Up 21-6. Buckeyes scored with the last series, running that ISO play along with Tempe Pearson. Pounding away. And Tempe again. Running out to the 45-yard line like a man possessed. When you talk about senior running backs and you talk to scouts around the NFL, they will say that this young man has a future on Sunday. Good blitz protector, runs hard, and they got to be impressed with what they're watching right now. And another Knoll is down, Dan.
And this is twice that Tay Cody has not been able to get up after a big hit on Pepe Pearson. So the body count is starting to increase for Florida State. And again, this is another defensive back. Remember, Samari Rule got hurt in the first half. Hurt the bottom of his foot. He's out for the rest of the night. Doesn't look good for Tay Cody right now. It's another determined run by Pepe Pearson. Cody's number 27. He comes in helmet to helmet. That's always a scary sight. The players hit head to head like that.
You know, Dan, that means that both corners for the Seminole defense have been knocked out of the game. Now, Roll has not returned. We'll see if he does. And it's nice to see the freshman is up. A man from Georgia got away from the Bulldogs. They had a renaissance come back this year, huh? Thomas, another freshman, will check in at the corner. He's out of Miami. There he is, number 41. Seymour in a defensive end. The fullback, Keller, right straight ahead. Smith, the safety, makes the stop, along with Coward. And Cody quickly returns.
Shows you how tough Tay Cody is. 5'11", 180 pounds, and that was... vicious hit, helmet to helmet with Pepe Pearson.
So he'll line up at that corner. Saunders has replaced Roll. Smith stays in at safety, and Jackson, of course, is the free safety. He has an interception. Toss down.
Pepe looks alley-wise, crosses midfield, and across the 40-yard line, all the way to the 37. And the Buckeye fans who have traveled to New Orleans are coming alive.
Now, Woody Hayes would be real proud of his Buckeyes tonight, especially in the second half. 16 yards that time for Pearson. Left side. Lumpkin gets a good seal block, and again, Matt Keller's out in front, kicking out the contain man, and Pearson is just getting every carry and loving every one of them. Not a bad half.
Rambo brings the play in, and he's the slot receiver, but they keep it right in Pepe Pearson's hands, and he is pounding away at the middle of that Florida State defense. They miss number 44, that middle linebacker, Darryl Bush. They simply are not stopping the Buckeyes now at the point of attack. So he's without his starting middle linebacker. He's without his starting left cornerback, and he's trying to hold up. But he does enjoy a 21-6 advantage, Mickey Andrews, the defensive coordinator.
And what Mickey's got to worry about now is the play-action pass. Jackson faking to Pearson and putting it up to one of his fine wideouts.
Pearson. Time number 45, Lamont Green, junior linebacker from Miami, stepped into the hole and made the stop.
There are times when Ohio State tries to stretch the defense with these almost draw play-like handoffs that they just take too much time, and the quickness of Florida State just takes over there. They're much more effective when they go straight ahead with the lead block and a quicker handoff.
Todd Fryer, the nickel man, comes in, and they put the pass rusher, Tony Bryant, also in the game. So Andrews substitutes four defensive players. He gets two fresh rushmen in the game. And on third down, Jackson complete to Rambo, the freshman, but that is short of a first down.
Short by about 2.5 yards, and John Cooper's going to have to make a decision on fourth down, and he's already made it.
So Stoltz jogs back onto the field. Strong leg. Remember, the Buckeyes faked one field goal in the first half, but the touchdown was called back. Illegal participation when Lumpkin, who caught the ball for a touchdown, did not come inside the hash. This is going to be a 46-yarder for Stoltz. He represents the only points for the Buckeyes. Pull this one to the left. And too far. Ball goes over to the Seminoles. So Pepe Pearson working hard this half, but the Buckeyes could not cash in. Right off his foot. He was hooking this one. We'll be right back to the Nokia Sugar Bowl.
No matter who you are, no matter where you're going, we'll keep you connected. Wireless technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people.
How long does it take to turn the new Dodge Durango from the sport utility with the most passenger room in its class into the one with the most cargo room? Not long enough. Durango, new ground for the new Dodge.
Welcome back to the Nokia Sugar Bowl, the Big Easy, New Orleans. With Dan Fouts and Jack Root, I'm Brent Musburger. Happy New Year, everybody. Certainly it's been a happy one for the Seminoles so far. Buckeyes struggling a bit, and you wonder with Jermaine on the telephone if he's going to come in on that next series. He's the quarterback next year when the season opens, no doubt for the Bucks. Busby now with Miner back in the game. Play fake to him. Goes long down the sideline. Plummer couldn't cover the man, but a penalty flag comes down. Warwick makes the catch anyway.
But did Warwick push off on Plummer?
Yes, he did. Buckeyes are celebrating over there. Offensive interference.
He had his hands all over Plummer. Busby with the play fake is just going to throw this as far as he can for his big playmaker, Peter Warwick. Good coverage by Plummer. There's the push. There's the catch, and there's the flag.
Not much, huh?
Just enough.
I don't know. I see a lot of contact with receivers and DBs now, right?
You got to call that.
Do you?
Yeah, it makes it for a much more interesting ball game.
Now you're thinking, Patsy, now you got the game plan.
It took me a while, partner. Yeah. 44-yarder wiped out, huh?
Keeps us alive with 130. Warwick not happy about that. I'll stand up for you, number nine. Don't worry. So Springer replaces him.
The ironic thing is I don't think Warwick had to push off or grab him at all because Plummer never looked back for the ball. He had no idea where the ball was.
Ball is brought all the way back to the 15-yard line. They'll make it first and 24 for the Noles. Here's Busby in trouble now, rolling back in the end zone. And he is. Did he step out? The safety. He did step out. No question. A safety, and the Buckeyes are going to get the ball right back.
Two guys made a great play on this one, Brent. Number 45 is Katzenmoyer. Watch him. He reads the fake, sees that it's going to be a screen pass to Miner, and then big Winfield Garnett chases Busby out of the end zone by a toenail. Give big Winfield 2 points.
And with 1:13 to go in the third, the Buckeyes are going to get the football back. So they dominate the third quarter. The big cat starts prowling a little bit. Must be a night linebacker.
That was just a great play. The fake was trying to hold him as they fake the draw play to Miner. And Katzenmoyer read the screen, gave Busby no place to throw the ball, and let old big old Garnett chase the quarterback out of the end zone.
So one of the big plays in this game now is that offensive pass interference on Peter Warwick.
44-yard gain wiped out. Next play, the safety. This is as close as it's going to get for a safety right there. Out of bounds. Boy, Ohio State's defense has stepped up, Brett.
Now we get to watch my man, Kanika.
Yeah, most teams use the punter in this situation.
Look at this. They're going to let him kick it off from the 20-yard line. That's how golden this leg is. Did you hear that crack, my friend? Drives wide inside the 10-yard line on one bounce. Sprints to the 22-yard line. What do you got?
72 yards. For Sebastian Janikowski.
Don't you ever go back to soccer, young man. My friend Dick Vermeil may need you in a few years.
All right, check out the play selection after halftime. Only two passes for Mike Jacobs and the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Well, let's see what the Bucks can do now. It's been a soft middle. Florida State needs to toughen up on the inside. They've got to stop Pepe Pearson. He's dominated them here in the third quarter. They step a linebacker up. Put a five-man front. And that time they wail away. about a yard. Sam Cowart was there. So now it'll be up to the Buckeye coaches to quickly readjust as Mickey Andrews changes his defensive front and he starts pressing with more linebacking muscle, stepping into the hole against Cooper's offense. You can watch at home, see how many men they step up now. They pull Coward off a little bit. They expect the Bucks to pass. They don't disappoint, and under fires all over Jackson, buried him at the 9-yard line. Oh, Greg Spires, the senior from Fort Myers, was all over the quarterback.
And Stanley Jackson's got to be wondering, where did he come from? Because he's a down lineman. Number 90 here, totally unblocked. Are you kidding me? Get out the playbook and show those offensive linemen you got to block the big guys.
Third down and 9. If ever Ohio State needed a play, here it is. Shotgun look for Jackson. Keller and Pearson in the backfield. Timeout, Jackson. The clock coming down, and he's forced to use a timeout. So he'll trot on over to the Buckeye sideline. His last game as a quarterback from Ohio State. John Cooper will turn it over to Joe Germain. Jackaroo.
Well, Brent, you may wonder, why is Stanley Jackson playing as much? We told you that John Cooper wanted to have him in there. But consider this fact, guys. You know, he is one of the captains of this team. And Dan Fouts, as you know, a leader really can rally the troops. And they seem to think that that's what Stanley Jackson can do. So far, he has produced. You can see the way he holds everybody together and also the way he tries to motivate everybody, especially like after that last play when a block was missed. He got up and he talked to the player and he said, hey, look, we got to do a better job. That's leadership. That's what Cooper wants right now with the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Yeah, something else, Jack. When Germain is in, as he was in the Rose Bowl, and he led that drive, remember, he had blockers like Orlando Pace on that offensive line. If the offensive line is not going to give you any more time than the Buckeyes do tonight, you need more mobility back there at that quarterback spot. Jackson can turn it loose and get downfield. I think Dan Fouts pointed that out at halftime. You give Joe Germain, though, a good offensive line and a strong look downfield, and he could terrorize the secondary.
Yeah, we haven't seen the last of Joe Germain. You see the chin strap buckled up. But this is Stanley Jackson's last game as a Buckeye. That means a lot.
Let's see if he can come with a big play, Dan. Third down. Back now in that shotgun look. Keller right to his left. Jackson sprints left. Now fire. Oh, and Wadsworth has got it at the 22. Big Andre Wadsworth. Along with muscle, he's also got finesse, and he can catch the football.
Stanley Jackson trying to make a big play. Here is Wadsworth. Jackson goes back to pass, and he's going to get chased out of the pocket. Then he's going to see if we freeze it right here. This is David Boston over the middle. That's where he's trying to go with the ball. There is Wadsworth. That's as good a play as you'll ever see a defensive lineman make.
His first interception ever as a Seminole, but remember, as a high school player, he was a tight end. And he battles to keep that ball alive. And now, Busby and the Noles looking to strike from the 22 in the shotgun. Three wideouts go downfield. Bobby Bowden says, let's get it in a hurry. Throws underneath and almost back into Buckeye hands. Berry just ran past it a little bit, covering Warwick on that far side.
Jackson talking to Mike Jacobs upstairs saying, coach just trying to make a play there. Now what they're on to, that is gone. Can't do anything about that play. Let's worry about the next series.
Now the heat is on the Buckeye defense. McClellan comes in, the nickel man. Three wideouts. Coles is to the short side. Now Miner gives him four wideouts. Dump to the middle, Green incomplete. Berry with great defense in the middle.
This is a great game by Gary Berry. I talked to Fred Puggins, the defensive coordinator for the Buckeyes before the game, and he said his main concern is how does Gary Berry hold up in pass coverage against the slot receiver.
Is there a penalty flag?
Certainly was a late one.
Yeah, late flag.
Dead ball.
Yeah.
Personal foul.
You bet.
Offense.
Oh.
Dead ball.
Killer.
Personal foul.
Oh, wait.
Defense.
Okay.
Offsetting penalty. Repeat the down.
That works against you when they say repeat that down.
Busby 0 for 3 here in the second half and has been sacked twice. One of those sacks went for a safety.
You know, I didn't happen to see anything, but it happened down on the field. And there's Wadsworth talking upstairs.
You know, you make an interception, you get to talk upstairs.
Here's third down and 10 for the Noles. Busby under pressure, going to take it off. Not going to get there. McClellan, the nickelback, forces him out of bounds at the 18-yard line. Field goal time for you-know-who. So when we come back with the fourth quarter, Bobby Bowden's team will be attempting to get 3 points back. And we will continue with the fourth quarter after these messages and a word from your ABC stations.
For 27 years, I've been Peanuts, see? So my pal Tony says, this Coors Light, they frost brew it, right? It's icy cold. So I says, I thought everyone drinks it because of all the Peanuts I've tossed. See, I could hit a guy 8 rows up just by hearing the sound of his voice. It was my thing. But with Coors Light, I don't need a thing. Except maybe a towel.
Coors Light!
Tonight's topic, Free Friday. Yeah. Sir, you played a critical role in the creation of the new Burger King fries that are being given away this Friday?
That's right, Bill. Free Friday.
Amazing. Now this.
The crispy new Burger King fries beat McDonald's fries in a nationwide taste test. Stop in Friday, January 2nd for a free small order.
Welcome back. Why give them away?
It's giving something back. I started from the ground up.
Literally.
They had a happy life until three teenagers decided to play a terrifying game.
The juveniles.
Rob Lowe.
I can't let this go.
Outrage, ABC Sunday.
Why the long face, Chunk?
It's my car.
Let me show you how things could have been.
Chrysler and Plymouth presents It's a Wonderful Event. Now get $1,500 cash back on Plymouth Neon. Get Chrysler Cirrus LXI at $18,995. Or get up to $1,000 cash back on Plymouth minivans.
Say, are you an angel?
You watch too many movies, friend.
Headed out for lunch? Consider this. The Big Mac has 31 grams of fat. The Whopper has 39 grams. To counteract the effects of a fat-filled lunch, choose the burger joint farthest from you and run there. Or go to Subway, where you can get a fresh sandwich under 6 grams of fat, made the way you want on fresh baked bread. Subway, the way a sandwich should be.
Out of cramp. Oh, walk it off. Hey, Helen, how you doing?
We'll say hello to 1998 tonight after the game.
This is college football on ABC Sports.
The Buckeyes leading the second half by 5 points, but Janikowski, 240-pound Janikowski, ready to attempt a field goal. The native of Poland, grew up playing soccer, joined his father Henrik in Daytona Beach, and after his father came here to play soccer, and look how high he whacks that ball through for 3 points for the Noles. So Janikowski regains 3 of the 5, and we will continue with the fourth quarter of the Nokia Sugar Bowl.
Hope my car gets fixed today.
And my seat. And my furnace.
And my lawnmower.
You idiot! You're gonna get us caught!
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down.
Eddie!
Make it a Bud Light. Another Nokia discovery. Small words are hard to read, which is why at Nokia, we make wireless phones with screens that are big, so they're easier to read. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia. Connecting people.
Are you gonna fix that fence today?
Yep.
1948 was the first year for Ford F-Series, and after 50 years, there are more tough F-Series trucks still on the road today than any other make. Ford F-Series, built Ford tough for 50 years strong.
It's been 50 years, huh? Well, maybe it's about time you fix that fence.
Yeah, honey.
The most dangerous enemies are those that hide in plain sight.
They look pretty human to me.
Premiering in 2 weeks on ABC. Prey.
Florida State closing out a great era with the seniors who are playing in their final game here. They lead it 24-8. Shanikowski wails away again. And it'll come out on the 20-yard line. You know, we asked Bobby about just how good this senior class has been. Here's what he had to say.
You know, this is as good a senior class as I've ever had. Now, there's a reason for that. They are older. They're more mature. We got more fifth-year seniors I can ever remember. I mean, we got 15 seniors. I bet you 12 of them are fifth-year seniors, you know. And so they've given us the leadership. They're the reason for our success.
Sam Howard, one of the fifth-year seniors. Statistically, this class has been responsible for 178 touchdowns, 1,400 points, better than 1,100 tackles, and 97 sacks. What a group of seniors. Jermaine returns, and on the release, he was hit.
And Greg Spires, one of those seniors, was the guy that was wrapping his hands around the throat of Joe Jermaine. Number 90 is Spires. Jermaine, five-step drop. And there's that pressure. And down goes Jermaine again. First play in, first play down.
D. Miller shuttles the play in for Cooper's Ohio State sideline. Wadsworth is in at left defensive end. And the Buckeyes will put a tight end, Lumpkin, over on him and run away from him. And here is Wiley behind Keller. Rackley, number 5, makes the stop for the Seminoles. And, Jackaroo, what a great collection of athletes Bobby Bowden has had coming through Tallahassee, huh?
Well, Brady's a hard taskmaster. You know, he requires 3 rules from his coaches, his staff, and his players. And they all know it by heart. First, he doesn't allow swearing. In fact, there's a fine jar that the coaches have to pitch in when they're reviewing film. Second, he doesn't allow drinking. That's enforced throughout the season. And third, and this is the best rule that Bobby Bowden has, have faith in the coach.
Yeah, exactly. Faith indeed. What a great job he has done since moving to that job from West Virginia. Remember, Florida State was a nowhere team when he went down there. Jermaine blindside down. Held on to the ball. Blitz by Todd Fryer. The man who has stepped in as the nickelback, and Jermaine never saw him coming.
Saw him coming because he came from his blind side off the slot, right side of the screen. Fryer with real good speed dropped his helmet right in the small of the back of Joe Jermaine. 4 sacks now for Florida State as they raise their total on the year to 68.
Folks, this team's not going to win a national championship, Florida State, but I'm here to tell you they can play with anybody in the land. You're going to have to. You just asked the Gators. They had to turn in some game to beat them. Now it is a high punt. Beister back. 44-yard line and down at the 45. Joe Jermaine over at that side. I'd be interested to ask him to compare the Michigan defense with the Florida State defense after the game. I want to see his comments. We'll be right back.
Cowkick.
mathematician can't explain how a car that broke all the molds still has enough power to keep blowing away the stereotypes. Ford Taurus SE Sport, now with a 200 horsepower Duratec V6. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Want whiter teeth in just 2 weeks? Then try Arm & Hammer Extra Whitening, the baking soda formula clinically proven to whiten teeth in 2 weeks. Arm & Hammer Extra Whitening, whiter teeth in just 2 weeks.
I'm getting the band back together.
The hottest, hippest, and most destructive band in history is ready for an encore.
Yeah!
Blues Brothers 2000, rated PG-13, starts Friday, February 6th.
I will not accept anything less than a perfect quad-twisting triple.
I will not accept anything less than my personal best.
I will not accept anything less than 80 miles per hour.
I will not accept anything less than 1 minute 17 seconds.
I will not accept any COD but Visa.
At the 1998 Olympic Winter Games, only the best is accepted. Visa, worldwide partner of the Nagano Games. It's everywhere you want to be.
As a new college professor, the Toolman finally gets to share his knowledge of cars.
I share that knowledge with you guys all the time.
Yeah, but now you'll be sharing it with someone who's actually interested.
A new Home Improvement Tuesday.
We're here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Bobby Bowden leading 24-8. And tomorrow at the Peach Bowl in Atlanta, game you can catch on ESPN, Terry Bowden will lead the Auburn Tigers against the Clemson Tigers. Might be kind of a tough, hard-hitting football game, that one in Atlanta tomorrow. You know that? Clemson's got a pretty good-looking linebacker. You and I like that. Simmons.
Sounds like a cat fight to me.
Yes, indeed. Now it's a handoff to Miner. Cut it back beautifully. A star of the future.
No question. True freshman. Having a heck of a day. 14 yards that time. Pretty good deception, too, by Busby as he carried out his fake.
You can see the bottom line.
Yeah, the bottom line to me, Brent, is that third quarter, Ohio State was dominant. Up and down the field, running the ball straight at Florida State. Coming away with 5 points, two of the five scored by their defense.
And again, that shotgun look. That Busby's the blitz. They hand it off to Miner. Nothing doing down at the line of scrimmage, right at the 40-yard line. It has been a pleasure watching the picture, my friend, offered up by our director, Drew Esserkamp. Our producer, Jimmy Russell.
Here, here. Happy New Year, boys. Great job today and all year long.
Patrick McManus back there on the replay truck. That's what happens to old directors, you know. This view offers you the seat you'd like to have in a football game, folks. Second down and 10. Busby. Fire. Coles, the receiver, Lavernius out of Jacksonville. Boy, do the Noles recruit some fine players out of the Jacksonville area.
And Brent, you talked about the fifth-year seniors and all of that. Bobby Bowden and the Seminoles are loaded. They played 33 freshmen this year. Think of that. 18 redshirts and 15 true freshmen.
Well, you can talk about the national championship, but to me, first things first, you got to win the state of Florida. Once you win that title, then, my friend, you're competing for the pickup. Third down, and Busby fires. Oh, is that interference? I don't see a flag.
Damon. Sure think so. Damon Moore running away from the scene of the crime. Busby comes up quick with this pass, and watch Moore come in just before. Yes, sirree, Bob, or Brent, you called it right. That should have been pass interference.
Whoa. Oh, yeah. That one's easy. But Cottrell, and to punt. Taking down some high snaps, hasn't he? causes him to hurry, and on it goes on into the end zone. What a great play that was, Michigan used. Set up field goal, pooch punt out of it late. Basically said, Ryan Leaf, if you can take it 96 yards, God bless you.
And 29 seconds, tough, tall order. Great season, though, for the Washington State Cougs.
Great figure skating coming up here in the next month or so on ABC. Saturday, the Equal World Challenge of Champions. And next Thursday, of course, our U.S. Championships. Who will represent this country at the Olympics upcoming in Japan? We're going to find out at the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. Don't forget, prime time coverage on Thursday. And here it is, Joe Germain, who checks on in with 10:41 to go. Tough hombre out of Mesa, Arizona. Pulls it back, far sideline, got Boston open. Boston was out of bounds at any rate. You know, one thing about Boston, young man that we were around and talked with, outstanding, and it was so unusual to hear him and see him pop off about Woodson prior to the Michigan game. I still can't get over that.
Well, I think he just got trapped in the emotion of a big game like that, and probably was just voicing his confidence in his own abilities. But what I didn't like to see is after he made the touchdown catch against Michigan, taunting Woodson with the ball. That is classless, and I'm sure he's very contrite about the whole situation.
One of the first phone calls that night was from his daddy, who's an official in the National Football League, a fine, outstanding young official, and he was not happy with that. Germain is back, snaps it off high, incomplete. Rambo, the freshman, had cut in. Now, the one thing that I want you to remember about this is that David Boston did score here on Woodson, who slipped down, but here is the taunting. And, of course, that's resulting in a penalty, and I'm sure it's something that the young man will not repeat. And he has a future ahead of him playing in his daddy's league, if we could call it that, although I'm sure that his father will not be officiating any of his games when he goes up to the NFL. He's an outstanding young talent. He'll be back in Columbus next year.
Yeah, the only problem is that everybody sees that, and then every game he's going to play now until his career is over, there's going to be some defensive back trying to get into his head.
Reggie Germany is in at wide receiver underneath Miller. Out of bounds, far side at the 25-yard line. Todd Fryer, who has been active. Remember, he's the nickel man. Saunders had to move over to the corner. Samari Roll. It was so unfortunate. The last time we see the number two, he was coming off the field because of an injury, and they retire that jersey tonight.
Yeah, you know, I get a feeling, though, that if Deion Sanders takes a liking to some young superstar cornerback here at Florida State, he may just say, son, you may wear my jersey.
You know, I wish that more stars would do that, to tell you the truth. I think it's great that Archie Griffin said he wanted Katsumori to wear 45 at Ohio State. I think it's terrific.
You ain't getting mine out of mothballs, buddy.
Oh, you're a hard man. Here's the fake. Up the middle, wide open. The short man. And that's Rudzinski, the linebacker, who busts it up the middle for 24 yards. Seems like I've seen that play before. Wasn't it Colorado State? Didn't my friend Sonny Lubick haul one in against Missouri with this? Well, now watch the punter go in the air.
And so did Washington against Michigan State. They went 64 yards for a touchdown on a play just like this. Rudzinski with the big play.
Here's Bartholomew. He's got to carry. Oh, bad snap.
This is what it looks like from behind the punter. That's the key block right there. That was Marcel Willis, number 46, with the trap block. That opened that huge hole. Great call by John Cooper. What do you got to lose?
24-8, 10-07, and Buckeyes, let's see if they get a lift out of that. Germain's got Wadsworth in his face and won't get away. Andre Wadsworth. If it wasn't for the presence of Peyton Manning and Ryan Leaf, this fella could well be the first player and still maybe, who knows. So much muscle, so much speed. And remember, a year ago, he was a defensive tackle. He had Peter Boulware and Reinhold Wilson outside of him at the ends. And they moved him outside to end in the spring. Coach Bowden wasn't too sure how it was going to work out. but it has worked out splendidly for the Seminoles. Thank you very much. Number 85, Mickey Andrews, going to miss him next year. Here comes Keller, the fullback. Fryer couldn't get him. Forced out of bounds by the freshman corner, Cody.
Now, remember, with 9 minutes to go in this ballgame, 9:06, Buckeyes trailed by two touchdowns and two-point conversions. So, at midfielder, imperative that they pick up a first down here and go down and score touchdowns. Enough of these field goal tries.
After the fake punt, Jermaine left with half a field. But the Noles have been extremely tough. Injuries and all. And you want to watch Sam Coward, number one. Jermaine slips, tries to regain it, gets away, picks up a block, fires down a far side, caught, Lincoln, touchdown! Ohio State! How about that one, huh?
The first thing that happens is Jermaine almost falls down by himself. He's been rocked so much in the pocket. Gets away from Bryant right there and now keeps his head up the field. Watch this catch by Sean Lumpkin. All 6'8", the basketball player reaches down and makes an unbelievable catch off his shoe tops, juggles once, and then dives and scores. Wow, what a play.
All right, Dan, here comes the two-pointer now. And the Bucks have to keep it going. 9 minutes.
They're 0 for 1 in two-point conversions this year, so they're due.
Pepe Pearson in at the tail. Jermaine looks right side, back of the end zone, incomplete. They fail with the two-point attempt. Miller being defended by Dexter Jackson. But the touchdown was set up by the fake punt. Bartholomew pretending to have the ball snapped over his head. Brzezinski, the linebacker, straight ahead. And from there, the Buckeyes march in for their first touchdown on a great effort by Lumpkin. I'm out at the Nokia Sugar Bowl.
Just as I thought, my cubicle is 2 inches smaller today than yesterday.
We install real-time status adjusters. Sensors monitor your work and adjust the cubicle size according to your value.
It's amazing how fast you get used to it.
Here's a business idea that actually makes sense. Free delivery from Office Depot on any order over $50. Everything you need delivered right to your door. Office Depot delivers. Business is crazy, but Office Depot makes sense.
Well, if I had money, I'd tell you what I'd do. Go downtown, buy a Ford truck or two. I'm crazy about a Ford truck. Lord, I'm crazy about a Ford truck. I'm gonna buy me a Ford truck and cruise it up and down the road. I'm gonna buy me a Ford truck and cruise it up and down the road.
For the last 50 years, there's only been one truck built Ford Tough.
It's another Rogaine Bowl report from the Rose Bowl. Once again, Brian Greasy, a great day. A little play action here, and he tosses this one deep. Ty Streets comes up with a touchdown, and he says they're national champs.
To come to the Rose Bowl and play a great Washington State team and win, you know, is there anything else? I ask you, is there anything else you want us to do, you know?
21-16, they have been crowned. Brent, back to you.
All right, John, thank you very much. And here, Florida State's lead over Ohio State has been whittled to 10, but it was a big miss on the two-pointer. We'll show you some replays on the touchdown and the missed conversion. Stringer, who has checked in, feels it at the one. Breaks free. Stringer with an alley. An impressive return to the 32, but we've got to go back and show you that touchdown catch by John Lumpkin, a junior.
He's only caught 15 balls all year. Dexter Jackson, not big enough to stop the 260-pound Lumpkin. This is why you make a basketball player into a tight end. He got great hands. Jackson is involved in the conversion attempt as well as he flashes right in front of D. Miller, gets a finger on the ball, and keeps Miller from converting.
Now the Noles will see what they can do about that time. At 8:44, they lead by two scores, up by 10. Miner stays in as tailback, and Busby gonna fire it downfield on first down, and E.G. Green. Oh, brother, what a catch. Winfield all over him, and somehow he makes the catch at the 26, a 42-yard gain.
I kind of like this type of football, Brett, you know? Let her rip, seven catches for 176 yards now for E.G. Green. Antoine Winfield was all over him.
And the Buckeyes need a stop here with E.G. Green averaging better than 25 yards a catch. With the time left, Buckeyes can ill afford to fall down by three scores. First down. And Miner squirts to the 21.
The big play has been the trademark of Florida State all year long. Came into today's game with 70 plays over 20 yards in distance, 17 of those touchdowns. Today they've had six of them, and that's got to make Mark Richt awful happy, the offensive coordinator and the quarterback coach.
7:49 on the clock. The Noles drive to the Buckeyes 21. Here's your second down. Buckeyes shift at the line as Glenn, the fullback, pounds inside the 20-yard line. This will lead third and short coming up here. And we welcome you Night Owls to the Nokia Sugar Bowl here in the Big Easy. The last one going down on New Year's Day, and it's been a good one. Hard-hit football. Florida State and Ohio State, 7:14 on the clock. And a monstrous third down play coming up here, Dan Faust.
And to paraphrase Marv Levy, where would you rather be than right here and right now?
Here it comes. And the Noles, realizing how important this is, are going to call a timeout. So we'll take a break at the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Be right back.
You don't need binoculars to see why Escort is so popular. It's a value so enticing, it's like getting cake with extra icing. You can get power, lots of power, power galore, to whisk down the windows and unlock the doors, adjust the side mirrors, but wait, there is more. Opt for a remote, AC, a smooth automatic, and a CD player for the music fanatic. And if that's not enough, you can get an anti-theft system to protect this good stuff. The buck starts here for Escort thrills, somewhat higher, loaded to the gills.
Tonight's topic, Free Friday. Yeah. Sir, you played a critical role in the creation of the new Burger King fries that are being given away this Friday?
That's right, Bill. Free Friday.
Amazing. Now this...
The crispy new Burger King fries beat McDonald's fries in a nationwide taste test. Stop in Friday, January 2nd for a free small order.
Welcome back. Why give them away?
It's giving something back. I started from the ground up.
Literally.
How do you catch an evil...
What goes around really goes around.
...that passes from person to person?
Beware my wrath.
High touch.
Put the gun down!
I'm a detective. My work is based upon evidence.
They can only survive in the bodies of others.
Haven't you done enough?
Denzel Washington, John Goodman, Donald Sutherland.
Leave my family alone.
Fallen.
But I'm still having fun.
Rated R. Starts Friday, January 16th.
ABC Sports presentation of the 1998 Nokia Sugar Bowl is brought to you by Nokia Wireless Phones. Inspired technology with a human touch. Ford F-Series, the best-selling trucks are built Ford tough. The NASDAQ stock market shaping the new world of investing. And Burger King, where you can get your burgers worth. Well, we've come down to third down and three for the Seminoles, leading at 24-14 by 10. 6:57 to go in the final quarter here at the Nokia Sugar Bowl. After a timeout, they have a deal already here. Mr. Fouts, what do you think they come up with here, partner?
Well, it's interesting a situation here. I think they're going to throw the ball.
Would not be unlike the Noles. And they're going to put it in Miner's hands, slant him, and he's not going to get it. Great defense. First of all, the linebacker, 52, came across. That was Kevin Johnson. Then it was Damon Moore, the safety, who cleaned up for the Buckeyes, and it is fourth down, field goal time.
This is excellent defense. Rudzinski is taken out by Thomas. There is Johnson, there is Moore, and there is no first down.
Janikowski, a 37-yarder.
I wonder if Janikowski didn't see Antoine Winfield coming in from the right side and at the last minute just yanked that ball wide right.
You don't want to say wide right around Bobby Bowden.
Well, it was. There's Winfield from the left side, and whatever they want to call that, Brent, it's no good.
That's a painful memory, partner, wide right. Oh, mercy. Yeah.
That looked like one of Charles Looper's passes.
Man who won $40,000 at halftime in the Nokia million-dollar toss.
Thank you very much.
Goes back home a happy man. 6:13 to go. Big miss. Trail by 10 instead of 13. Now it's up to Jermaine and the Bucks to get something going again. Miller. Jermaine. Underneath and brought by the running back who had slipped out Keller into that flat.
Yeah, that ball was thrown behind Matt Keller. Keller's had a busy day. Had a couple of carries, but primarily he's been the lead blocker for Pepe Pearson and the pass protector for both Stanley Jackson and Joe Germain.
Just about half the figure that the Buckeyes need a touchdown drive here. 6 minutes to go.
And they got to do it in a hurry because they're down by 10, so that means they need two scores.
80 yards away. Second down. Jermaine. And Pepe Pearson had slipped a bit too far ahead of him that time, and Wadsworth was coming hard off the edge. Jermaine did not have a whole lot of time, and they didn't hook up.
Now, this is real good pressure again as that ball just looked like it slipped out of Jermaine's hands. Pearson did not run that bad a pattern to be missed by that much.
Let me check that. That was Theon Rackley, the rover, who came up and blitzed. And he was bringing most of the heat. And now Jackson checks in. Stanley Jackson will handle his third and 10. He'll sit back with his shotgun. He's going to try to run out of it. And nothing doing. Wadsworth will not let him have an inch.
Stanley Jackson being the sack by Andre Wadsworth.
That shows you Wadsworth is a smart player as well, because he sees that Jackson's in the game, and he knows that Jackson's first instinct, if somebody's not open right now, is to take off running. They now have sacked the quarterback 70 times this year.
Too many men on the field, and then they go off on the wrong side. They had a Buckeye leave the field on the Florida State side. And he said, I thought I could go off on any side here.
David Mitchell, number three.
We don't see him very often, and he just...
Illegal substitution on the offense.
He just paid a visit over here to the Knowles side. And they'll remind him that you have to leave on your team's side.
Maybe he's colorblind or something.
That could be. Feaster standing back at the Knowles 41. Zinsky'd love to do it again, but he's not the favorite to get another fake ball here. Feaster, 35-yard line. Down at the 41-yard line here. 4:50 left in the Nokia Sugar Bowl, and the Seminoles up by two scores, 24-14.
Every year I try to quit smoking cold turkey. This year is my year. I'm committed. I'm psyched. And I have helped Nicorette Gum to help control my cravings. It's not like the patch. Nicorette lets me decide how much nicotine to use and when to use it, so I can stop smoking now. The idea is, by this time next year, to save enough money by not smoking, to be not smoking in Cancun.
Nicorette Gum helps you fight your cravings, your habit, your way. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
All right, you got the list on you?
Yeah, I got the list right here.
We're going to Napa. It's the best place for parts.
Fine. You know what? If I ran Napa, here's what I would do. I would widen the aisles a little bit. I would put a brand new sign so it would make things easy to find.
Okay.
And I'd have a state-of-the-art computer system to be able to find those parts like that.
Okay, but you've got to admit, you can't beat Napa for the knowledge. I mean, they carry more parts than anybody.
I agree.
You agree for a change.
Yes, for a change. All I'm saying is they should fix the stores up a little.
Wow.
I could live with this.
You say either, I say either.
I say neither, you say neither. Either,
either,
neither,
neither.
Let's call the whole thing off.
You like potato, I like potato.
I like tomato, you like tomato. Potato,
potato,
tomato,
tomato.
Let's call the whole thing off.
Call everything off and go exploring in a Ford Explorer.
A little past midnight in the east. That means it's past 11 here in the Big Easy as we welcome you back to the Nokia Sugar Bowl and we start to wrap up our festivities. And, thanks to the folks, both these schools, Steve Snapp at Ohio State, Rob Wilson at Florida State, for their help getting ready for this one. Of course, all the officials of the Nokia Sugar Bowl helping our crew. All the cameramen and technicians who brought you the coverage tonight. Here's the end around. Coles with great speed and Moore wasn't buying it. What a game he's played. Number 13.
Both safeties for Ohio State really have done a great job. They've been called upon to crowd the line of scrimmage and try to make tackles behind. Coles is a speedster, but watch as Moore comes up, bites off the stiff arm, and brings him down for his eighth tackle of the evening.
So Coach Rick would like to have that call back, but you know, I talked about the durability of this coaching staff, if you will. A remarkable 144 years of collegiate coaching experience on Bowden's staff. Here's Miner out to the 36. And they've got three coaches who have been at Florida State for 10 years or more. Wow, and next year, of course, the Super Alliance, if we can call it that, and Rick would like to start the season, preseason number one, because look what's ahead here on ABC. Friday night, you'll have the CompUSA Florida Citrus Bowl, the Rose Bowl, and the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Then Saturday night, after a couple of NFL games, will be the FedEx Orange Bowl, and then the rotation begins for the national championship. The Fiesta Bowl, winning the flip, and the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl will bring you the first one versus two game. In other words, this year, Nebraska and Michigan would have met. Anyway, Busby fires. Warwick got it out of bounds at the 40-yard line against Winfield.
That's the one thing about Florida State is they see great cornerbacks every week, and they throw the ball in practice against great corners. Busby does a great job here of anticipating Warwick's break under pressure from Kevin Johnson. Now watch as Warwick goes down, fakes the post route, and then turns back to the corner. The ball's in the air, right on the nine.
Wouldn't it be fun if after the game tomorrow night is all over, you pick two teams. Say Nebraska wins, or you pick Michigan. Nebraska have a one-game shootout. Let's say they don't. Then you have Florida State, Michigan. I can keep the season going for a while. No problem.
Dream on, partner.
Yeah. First down and 10. Here's the blitz against the run. Penalty flag is down. Minor to the 36-yard line. Minor going to be one of the reasons why the Seminoles, if they're not the preseason number one, they're going to be close to it.
Offside. On a defense. Lined up in a neutral zone.
What a reminder. Monday Night Football no longer with us on ABC. Off season, and so we'll have America's Funniest Home Videos 2020 doing a new night and the practice a new night. So that starts on Monday night.
You talked about next year for Florida State, friend. Travis Minor, a freshman. He's going to have a great quarterback battle, too. Dan Kendra, number 10 here. He's an exciting player. He's going to have to fight off the challenge of Chris Winkie, 26-year-old.
You know, it's interesting. You go back, I saved all those preseason magazines. You know, Sports Illustrated picking Penn State, Sporting News at Colorado.
They got to work harder.
And I wonder if Brian Greasy will remind Bob Greasy that Bob has picked Washington.
Oh, yes. In his magazine, he had the Huskies.
I wonder who Jack Arut picked.
Yeah, Jack, who did you pick as your preseason number one? Fess up, partner.
There's no way. I would never tell. But I want to tell you a story about Tad Busby. You know, he enrolled in Bobby Bowden's football camp in Birmingham, Alabama. And he went there with another high school quarterback by the name of Peyton Manning. They roomed at camp, and Bobby Bowden took Busby aside and told him he had all the tools to play football on the college level. Until then, Busby didn't believe it. He went home and said, Dad, I'm going to play football, and I'm going to play at Florida State.
Miner is tripped up. The big cat coming across. You know, there's some of those folks who did some offensive line work for us all year long that we want to give thanks to. As you watch the big cat, what a future he has ahead of him. Wrapping up the linebacker there, grabbing him by the shoelaces. The assistants to our producer, Elizabeth Reel and Brian Lockhart. Good luck to both. Thanks for all the help. Our stats man, Roger Riley, who stepped in, and our spotter, Brian Bobison, extremely happy because he had a big wager with his wife. She graduated from Washington State, he being a Michigan man. So I guess he doesn't have to take the garbage out this year. Whatever. Busby off a play fake, fires into Warren. Great grab by Warren at the 1 yard line.
Now this is a quarterback just letting his great athletes at wide receiver make plays. This is good coverage by Plummer again. But just throw it up there and have the confidence that your guy is going to come down with it. Peter Warrick and E.G. Green have been outstanding tonight doing exactly that.
So this is about to put it all away. Until another year at the Nokia Sugar Bowl. That's William McCray. And he pops it in for his second touchdown of the game. Might want to ask Coach Cooper over there whose buddy was talking about.
Illegal participation on a defense. Penalty is declined.
Can't even do it with 12 men, John. Had a pep rally. And, of course, you know how you're firing up those pep rally deals. John says, we're going to kick their butts. And everybody roars and roars. And, of course, there was a newspaper man there. You know that's going to get out.
Absolutely. And although I don't think that Bobby Bowden and his Seminoles took him all that seriously. I think talent wins out here more than that
say,
type of motivation.
If you had this team, would you be concerned about that? Janikowski rifles in the extra point.
Cooper is just doing his Steve Spurrier imitation anyway.
Look at a big hug down there. For Pittman, that defensive front did a heck of a job. They set the tone for the Seminoles tonight. And of course, when you know that Tom Osborne's stepping down, and you wonder about Bobby Bowden, so we asked him, any thoughts of retirement dancing through your mind, and here's what he had to say.
Not one bit. Not one bit. I really hated to see Tom retire because he means so much to the game. I'm thinking there goes an icon that younger coaches need to watch, you know? And I've been asked that a lot. Well, I guess Coach Bowden's, he must be thinking about, no, I have no desire to retire. I'm 8 years older than Tom, but still, for some reason, I don't seem hardly to understand why, I have no desire to quit coaching.
That's great, because we love seeing Coach Bowden and his great coaching staff. He enjoys it, you know? It's easy to enjoy the wins. Tom Osborne had a fantastic career, won 250 games faster than anybody else. But college football needs Bobby Bowden, and I hope that Tom Osborne finds a way of staying involved as well. Even when he loses, partner, it's an entertaining football game. He flames out. I'm going to tell you that right now. So with 44 seconds, it'll come out on the 20-yard line. And a couple of Warriors there. Season all done, and Bowden, one of the first things he'll do is go over and find Coach Cooper. John and he, of course, have traveled to a lot of Nike clinics through the years. Their families are friendly and good friends. And lurking there, they're going to give the old coach a bath.
Gotta find one with some water in it,
yeah,
though.
I can't believe how successful his children are as coaches, too. That's just wonderful. Joe Germain will wrap this one up. Next year's quarterback, there was movement. And the whistle is sounded. Buckeyes will be back next year. They will be a strong contender for the Big Ten Championship. This is a very talented team next year.
Yeah, I think John Cooper's excited about the prospect of having Joe Germain as his senior quarterback and throwing the ball a little bit more. And I know one thing, this early season schedule, West Virginia, Toledo, that's a pretty good schedule for Ohio State, especially they get a couple of those big guys in Columbus, right?
So the Seminole celebration has begun here on the near sideline. Last 40 seconds. Incomplete. I think one of the biggest things about the Buckeye schedule is the fact that both Penn State and Michigan must come to the horseshoe to play next year. Of course, right, you may have noticed it doesn't matter where Michigan plays Ohio State. I know that's such a painful memory. When you mention that, but Coop's record over the last two games, including Bulls, has not been good except for his great success at the Rose Bowl last year. Incomplete. Ball hit the ground. Yes, indeed. Let the good times roll with the Noles. Just one series, they let it get away from them in Gainesville. Well, this team would be battling for a national championship tomorrow night against Nebraska down in the Orange Bowl. That's how close they came.
Really, it was just a three-play series, and it was a 64-yard bomb.
Yeah.
Jaquez Green.
Jaquez Green. Oh, Jaquez Green is a great player. Third down. Side handoff. The Warriors start shaking hands now. Now that's when you know you're going good in the South. You get your own troop. You know, Coach, nice going, Coach.
You bet.
John will come across. They'll shake hands and start looking ahead to next year because this one's headed for the mothballs. Florida State. wins the Nokia Sugar Bowl 31-14, and they did it very impressively. The Seminoles, the winner of the Nokia Sugar Bowl. Let's send you back to New York now.